Class of 3C is happy to perform the story of Hansel and Gretel and the Creepy Woods, as adapted by Jeanette J. Quish. So sit back and enjoy the show. Once upon a time, a long, long time ago, there lived a brother and a sister named Hansel and Gretel.
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel.
Yes. Just as we said, they lived in a cottage in the woods with...
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel.
Enough! They lived in a cottage in the woods with their father, who loved them very much, and their stepmother, who had her sanity to consider.
Husband, your children are driving crazy.
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
Take them into the woods and leave them.
But darling, they'll be hungry.
Don't worry, nice witch will feed them gingerbread.
Oh, they like that. Okay, come on, kids.
So the typical clueless father took Hansel and Gretel far, far away and left them. However, he made one mistake. Instead of taking them into the woods...
Why did Daddy leave us in the weeds?
Ow, they're all prickeries.
Hansel and Gretel stood around in the prickly, stickery weeds, waiting for their father.
Ow!
Ow!
Owie!
Owie!
Finally, Gretel realized he wasn't coming back.
Daddy's not coming back. How will we find a way back to our house?
Look, you can see it. It's right over there.
So they walked home and jumped on the couch and got prickers all over it.
I'm Hansel, Hansel, Hansel.
I'm Gretel, Gretel, Gretel.
We're Hansel, Hansel, Hansel. And Gretel, Gretel, Gretel.
Your stepmother heard the noise and came out to see.
Oh, they're back.
Their stepmother had a splitting headache when she called her husband.
Husband!
Yes, dear?
She told him where to take those noisy children.
Take those noisy children over the hill and deep into the forest and leave them.
But darling, they'll get hungry.
Don't worry, the seven dwarfs will feed them.
Oh, they like that. Okay, come on, kids.
So their father took them over the hill and through twisted, scary trees, past the den of hideous, smelly, unsupervised creatures who watched them as they passed through the clearing. Their father patted on them their head, gave them some words of wisdom.
Say hello, Caesar, for me, buckets.
Their father headed home wishing he was having gingerbread for breakfast.
Gingerbread.
Hansel and Gretel stood around as the forest got darker and darker.
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
Hansel and Gretel stood around as the forest got darker and darker. The crickets chirped.
Chirp, chirp.
The owls hooted.
Woo, woo.
The moon came out.
Ah.
And the wolves howled.
Woo.
Hansel and Gretel began to realize the danger they were in.
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
Huddle closer, children, in the woods, in the woods, in the woods, very far from home.
It is getting darker in the woods, you are all alone.
Silly children, wake up. You don't know, you don't know, you don't know what is in the woods. Build a fire, climb higher, find a way to survive.
Do you hear that branches breaking?
Something flew across the moonlight.
I can breathe from cosmos danger. Branches can't stay awake.
Huddle closer, children, in the woods, in the woods, in the woods. Very far from home. There are dark things lurking in the woods, in the woods, in the woods. Eat you to the bone. Silly children sleeping, we will stay, we will watch, we will fight. What is in the woods?
With our sharp teeth.
With our long claws. We will help you survive.
Roar!
Yawn. Oh my, it's morning. I must have fallen asleep. Looks like it was an uneventful night. Gretel shook Hansel awake.
Hansel, it's morning.
I'm hungry. What's for breakfast?
You are cheating. Oh, I mean you darling children. Oh, you darling children are having breakfast with me.
Hansel
and Gretel introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Hansel.
Hi, I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel. And I'm a nice old lady. My house is right through those trees.
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel.
Enough! Walk this way.
The nice old lady was really a wicked witch who liked to eat children. She took them into her house. Gretel looked around.
I thought you would have a gingerbread house.
Oh, those property taxes were killing me.
Hansel was getting hungrier, so he asked again.
I'm hungry. What's for breakfast?
Something delicious, but first you must wash up.
The witch invited them to hop into a big pot of hot water. She said,
Scrub-a-dub-dub, into the tub.
Why are there carrots, potatoes, and celery
floating in the bathtub?
Those are bath toys.
So Hansel and Gretel, who never wore the brightest candles on the cake, hopped into the pot.
La 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 la.
For Pete's sake, sit down, you'll never cook. Get squeaky clean.
Okay,
curse flash.
The witch began to add some salt and spices while Hansel and Gretel splashed away in the blissful ignorance of their impending doom.
A pinch of this, a sprinkle of that.
What are you sprinkling on us?
Bubble powder.
More bubbles, hooray!
There's a knock on the door.
Knock, knock, knock.
I don't know what I've been told.
Those guys got pots of gold.
Do not grab them by the legs.
Their feet smell like rotten egg.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Guess who's knocking at the door?
5, 6, 7, 8.
Doors don't like to suffer late.
Sound off.
1, 2.
Sound off.
3, 4.
Shouldn't there? Shouldn't there be 7?
What happened?
To stew it instead of cookies.
I wanted to go.
Attention, pleased to meet you. I'm Bossy.
I'm Smelly.
I'm Clumsy.
I'm Sleepy.
I'm Whiny.
I'm Achoo!
And he's
Sneezy.
We're here to wish you a good day.
We live in a cottage down the road, and we just passed by when we came under the spell
of a most delicious, bewitching smell
of cinnamon, fingers, and margarine.
So if you don't mind, may you come in?
You are in.
Hansel jumped up and hollered.
Hey, Sneezy.
Achoo!
My dad says hi.
The 7 dwarves were real moochers. They started scrawling to ground for something to eat. They hadn't had a hot meal since Snow White married the handsome prince and moved away. But all they found were hideous gargoyles. But the dwarves knew they smelled something good. They followed their noses until they found
a big pot of soup.
Soup?
Where?
I'm hungry. Children's soup!
Eek!
The dwarves tried to rescue the children. Unfortunately, they weren't very organized. But they only made it worse. The dwarves yelled for the children to get out.
Get out of the soup pot, that witch wants to cook and eat you.
But the children have been in the hot water too long.
I'm melting.
Me too.
Hansel and Gretel fainted in the hot water, and it was getting hotter. Bossy tried to lift them out.
1, 2, 3, lift!
But the witch flapped her arms and yelled,
Stop that right now!
The leader of the elves was very brave.
Let them go, you mean old witch.
You let them go, I'll turn you all into dwarf hamsters.
Dwarf hamsters, that'd be so cute.
The elves let go. They were afraid to be turned into dwarf hamsters. Their leader had an idea. She told Gretel.
Gretel, call your fairy godmother.
Gretel, wake up!
Gretel, call your fairy godmother.
Gretel, wake up!
Calling fairy dog mother.
In a blinding flash of light, there appeared.
Woof! What are you?
Gretel's fairy dog mother.
No, Gretel, call your fairy godmother.
Call calling Fairy Frog Mother.
And with another blinding flashlight, there appeared
Ribbit.
What are you?
Gretel's Fairy Frog Mother.
No, no, better call you Fairy Godmother.
She's asleep.
She can't call anymore.
How about Hansel? Can he call his Fairy Godmother?
This looks bad. Hansel and Gretel are almost gravy, and instead of a fairy dog mother, we have a fairy dog mother.
Woof.
And a fairy frog mother.
Ribbit.
It looks like there will be no happy ending to this story. The elves burst into tears.